Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic determination of molecular formula of an organic compound. Hello friends, in the last lecture we have discussed about what is empirical formula, what is molecular formula and what is the relation between them, and that we have discussed that how can we determine the empirical formula of a given organic compound. So based on that only we are going to do a numerical, so let us talk about that one. So this is a question which is based on to determine the molecular formula of a compound, and the question is in this way, that is, an organic monobasic acid consists of 18.6% of carbon, 1.55% of hydrogen and 55.04% of chlorine, and the molecular mass of that organic compound it was found to be 129. So on that basis we have to calculate what is the molecular formula. So this all data are been given to us, and the thing is, by the quantitative analysis we have got the values of the carbon, hydrogen and here it is chlorine. So suppose by calculating or by sum up of all this, that is percentage of carbon, hydrogen and chlorine, if we have got 100%, then we can say that oxygen is not been present, and if anyhow if it is not been covering to 100%, that means the amount that is been left out so as to complete 100% will be nothing but the percentage of the oxygen atom. So based on that only what we are going to discuss, we are going to fulfill the data. So for that, so as to make the numerical very in a simplified manner, so the thing that is we have to do is we have to draw this kind of that is diagram over here, as you could see over here, that is this tabular form, and that is one consists of elements, one is of percentage composition, the next is atomic ratio and the next is simple ratio. So the elements that are being present over here is basically carbon, hydrogen and it is said to be chlorine. So the percentage of the carbon it has been said to be, that is 18.6, so I would write it over here like just 18.6 because it has been covering the percentage over here. Talking about the next thing, that is for hydrogen it has been given as 1.55, and that of the chlorine it has been given as 55.04. so if I sum up all those this numbers, so I can't get it 100. So that is the reason that the remaining part is of oxygen. So therefore another element is also been involved in this case, which has been not mentioned in the question, so, and that is oxygen. So therefore the oxygen will be nothing but, if I sum up this whole thing and if I the number, if I subtract it with 100, so therefore let us see what is the number that we could get. So we have got, that is 24.81% of the oxygen that has been present in the terms of percentage in the organic compound, and this is the thing that we have did. And talking about the next one, that is atomic ratio, how can we calculate the atomic ratio? So this is the percentage that we have got, or we could say that this much gram of the carbon has been present in the overall organic compound, and we could say that the atomic ratio is very easy to calculate. That what we have to do is we have to divide the percentage composition with that of the atomic mass of that respective atom of the particular element. So therefore in this case it is 18.6, so therefore since it is, we are talking about carbon, so therefore 18.6 divided by the atomic mass of the carbon. So let me write it over here like this one, and for carbon it is basically 12. So therefore the answer for this one could be, it is found to be, that is 1.55. talking about the next one, that is for hydrogen, again the percentage composition has been given, that is 1.55, and talking about the atomic mass of the hydrogen atom, it has been found to be 1. So therefore 1.55 divided by 1 is nothing but 1.55. talking about the another one, that is for chlorine percentage has been given, so I could write it as 55.04 divided by the atomic mass of the chlorine, and it has been found to be 35.5. so if I do this thing, so let us see what we could get. So again we have got, that is 1.55, and let us talk about that is oxygen atom. So therefore the percentage is given as 24.81 divided by the oxygen's atomic mass has been found to be 16. So if we do this thing, then let us see what is the mole atomic ratio that we could get. So again we have got it as 1.55. so this is the atomic ratio that we have got, and I have told you that how can we calculate the atomic ratio. And talking about the next one, that is how can we do the simplest ratio. So the smallest number in this atomic ratio is nothing but we could call it as 1.55, and the highest number is again 1.55. so the thing that we have to do is we have to we have to divide, that is the atomic ratio with the smallest atomic ratio that we have got over here, and it has been 1.55. So therefore, if I do this thing, that is 1.55 divided by 1.55, ultimately I'll get the answer as 1. Here also 1, 1, and 1. So this is the atomic ratio that we have got over here. And what does the simplest ratio we could determine from the simplest ratio? We could determine that this much is the atom that has been present in the organic compound, and that also in the simplest ratio, and that means, yes, that means empirical formula. So therefore, it has clearly indicated that the carbon, hydrogen, chlorine and oxygen are present in a ratio of 1:1:1, making this ratio to be called, when we write in the terms of a formula, then it is called to be, that is the empirical formula. So therefore, I could easily write, therefore the empirical formula is nothing but C:1, H:1, chlorine:1 and oxygen is also 1. So therefore I could write it as CHCl and O. So this is what we have calculated, the empirical formula. And once we have calculated the empirical formula, so therefore it will be very much easy for us to calculate the empirical formula mass, or so therefore that could be also written as So what we will do is we will sum up of all the atomic mass of the respective elements, and let us see that what is we could get. So this is the method to determine the empirical formula mass. So talking about the carbon, carbon is nothing but it has atomic mass of 12, that of the hydrogen it is 1, that of the chlorine it is 35.5, and that of the oxygen is that is 16. So if we calculate this thing, so let us see what is the empirical formula that we could get, empirical formula mass that we could get. So we have got it as 64.5. So this is the empirical formula mass that we have got, and that is found to be 64.5. So the only thing that we have to do is we also know the molecular formula mass. So let us write it over here. And the molecular formula mass, it was been given as 129. So I will write it over here as 129. So this is what we have got, that is we have no molecular formula mass, we know the empirical formula mass, and the thing is very easy for us to calculate the N. Yes, this N, which has a formula of, that is molecular formula mass divided by empirical formula mass. So the only thing that we have to do is we have to substitute the values over here. So therefore we could substitute over here as, that is for the molecular formula mass we have got, that is 129, and that for the empirical formula mass we have got 64.5. So therefore that could be divided in this form, that is 2. So therefore in this case the value of N is what we have got it as 2. But we know the another formula, and that is basically molecular formula is equals to N into empirical formula. So in this case the value of N, that is what we have got it as 2, and that of the empirical formula it was found to be, that is this one, that is CHClO. So if you multiply it by each of the element, so therefore we could get it as C2H2Cl2 and O2. So therefore we could easily say that this is nothing but the molecular formula of that particular organic compound, and this is all what we have calculated because of the quantitative analysis of the elements, and yes, by the atomic ratio, and this is how we have calculated the molecular formula and empirical formula. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got to know that how to calculate the molecular formula or empirical formula of a given organic compound, regarding if you know the quantitative analysis, or if we have did a quantitative analysis and we have got the percentage of the elements that have been present in the organic compound. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.